In this video, I'm going to show you how to make flowers in Affinity Designer just using the shapes. And I'm going to show you about six of them like these right here. But once you learn these techniques, you can make hundreds of different flowers. And I'm going to show you how you can use them on print on demand in places like Redbubble and Merch by Amazon. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005, and I got another Affinity Designer tutorial for you, and this one is about flowers. So these are gonna be great for spring. Spring's coming up. It's gonna be here before you know it, and we're gonna make flower patterns. Now, flower patterns do well on pop sockets and on phone cases, and can be used on a variety of products on places like Redbubble and Zazzle and Cafe Press and all of those places. So I'm gonna show you how to make flowers. I'm gonna show you about six of them here in Affinity Designer, but you can make so many more with the techniques that I'm gonna show you. It's gonna be super easy. It's all in Affinity Designer. So this technique is gonna be using the shapes in Affinity Designer, and we're gonna move things around. I'm gonna show you how to do it, exactly how to do it. And then at the end of this video, I'm gonna show you how I put it all together in kind of a pattern, just a real easy pattern, and then show you what it looks like on Redbubble products and Merch by Amazon products. So let's get into Affinity Designer right now. So here we are in Affinity Designer. These are the six flower shapes I'm gonna show you, but by the end of this, you're gonna be able to make so many more. So let me show you how to do this. So the first thing we wanna do is go to shapes. So click on here and you can see all these shapes. So we're just gonna use a few of them. You can use other ones too, but let me show you some of these. The first one, the easiest one to understand is this one right here, the cloud tool. So that's what we're gonna do, cloud tool. And I'm gonna bring it up here. You can see right now I have an arrow set on here, so let's change the color to just make it a black. Get rid of the stroke and then fill it with black. We're gonna change the color later, but we're gonna do this right now. So black, just so we can see the easiest. You can see this is that one right there, the cloud tool. So you're gonna notice, I'm gonna bring this up here so you can see the different things. Here are the number of bubbles. So you can count them 12, you can bring them all the way down to I believe 4, and then drag it as many as you like so you can see how many different flowers you can make. You can see that would be a cool flower right there already. So let's do 12, and then we can change the radius. Check this out. Let me change the radius, that goes in like that. So look at all these flowers that you can make. Look at that. Just with this one thing here. Changing the radius, coming in and out, right? And changing the bubbles, how many leaves, how many petals you want on your flower. Super simple, right? And all I did was I put a circle in the middle. So grab a circle here and hold down shift while you drag like this. And then change this to another color so it can be whatever color. I used white in the example down here. And then with your guides locked right here, you can see it centered it. So there you go. Simple flower, very easy to do. All right, let's do the star. I bet you didn't know that the star could be made into these flowers, right? So these are two stars. To get the star, you go to the shapes palette and go down to star tool and just do star like that. Let's change this to black again so you can see. All right, so we got the star here. Now this one has a little bit more things that you can do. So points again, 5, that's just like the leaves, the petals. So you can see so many different numbers here. So let's do 12, that worked last time. Inner radius, check this out. You can go bigger or smaller, right? Outer circle, you can curve it with the stars, isn't that cool? And inner circle is the inside, you can make it bigger or fatter. So you can see the one I have down here, the inner circle is a lot lower. The outer circle is a lot bigger. See that? And the radius comes down like this. You can see this coming together now. And as you play around with it, you'll get other ones too. So have fun with that. That is this one. Now the other one right here has curved edges. So you might have seen this right here, curved edges. So if we click that, we're gonna have to change it to like 6. what do we have here? 6, and then move these around 2. We're going to curve that side, and we're going to curve this side. Whoops. We're going to curve that side, and we're going to curve this side. Look at that. That's pretty cool, right? So we don't have to curve it as much. Make sure the left and the right curve are the same. So if this is 50, then this will need to be 50 right here. Like that. Or if this is 75, this will be 75. Just so it's the same. You can see that. And then your inner radius can come down. Boom. Now these could have circles in the middle too. I didn't put them on here, but if we did the circle in the middle, just hold down shift and change the color of the circle. Nice flower, right? And again, these could be multiple petals. Look at that. Look how many flowers you can make with that, right? So very easy. So no, those are those three right there. Now let's do this one. This is an odd shape for a flower, but let me show you what it is. This one is called Square Star Tool. So click on that. Kind of do that. Let's make it black. And this one has a few things. Let me move it here. Okay, so sides, we can make as many sides as we want. And you can see that's pretty much what we got here. And the cutout, you can make it go bigger or smaller. So you can make like a flower like this or a flower like that. And again, you can put a circle in the middle. Real easy to make it look like a flower. So let's do that. Circle. Boom. Look at that. Pretty cool flower, right? All right, so this one doesn't have curved edges. It's very straight flower, but has a nice, a little different than what we have here. So the next one is the Cog Tool. Let's see right there. So click on your shapes again, Cog, right there, bring it. Let's change this to black. Okay, so teeth, you can see that's just how many petals. Again, if you're thinking flower radius, you can see it comes down like that. That looks like a really cool flower already, right? And you can see whole radius, that's the, this one actually has a circle in the middle, so we don't have to do one. And then tooth size, you can make this bigger or smaller. And curvature, this kind of curves and stuff. So I think what we did on this one, can't remember. Oh yeah, I went all the way to the edge. So this is kind of a knocked out version of it. So behind here, the round circle is actually the flower. So it looks like a flower here, but this black part is the thing. So kind of a cool way to do kind of an inverse flower. And you can do it like that. So kind of a cool, almost sunflower looking thing right there. All right, so that's this one. Last one here is this star, kind of a funky looking star. And that is the double star tool. So you can do that. And points again. So you can see it goes in and out, in and out. So that can give you some cool effects right there. And again, with the inner radius and the outer radius, things like that. So I believe we went outer radius. Oh, there we go. So if we bring the point radius all the way in and then bring this one all the way out, you got some funky stars like that. Now, one thing I wanted to show you is something I didn't know about, and there are preset flowers in here. So let's copy all of these up and I'll show you what I mean. Holding down option, I'm just dragging these. Click, option, drag, click, option, drag, click, option, drag. All right, check these out. So if you go here to this cog and you hit presets, you'll have a whole bunch of other presets. Well, this one doesn't have many because it just has two, but check this one out. Look at that. Look for flowers here. So if you ever get stuck and don't know what to do, that's a pretty cool shape. You can click on these. This one has it too. Every shape inside of Affinity Designer has some preset stuff, some more than others, but Like some are really cool. Look at this hazard right there. And that, and let's check this one out. You got stuff like that and things. So play around with this. If you're not sure what yours will turn out, play with these cogs and things, and it'll be really fun. All right, so now that we have the flowers, we got all our shapes. You might have made different ones on your own. Let's color them and make them into a pattern. So I got colored some right here. And all I did was I went to the internet and I looked up vintage 70s palette and I found this one and I just brought it in. And all I'm doing is coloring it. So I'll show you what I mean. I'm gonna bring one over from here. Let's bring this guy over. So I'm just using my eyedropper and eyedropping this and then hitting it, right? And then my circle like that. And then taking one of these colors and dropping it. So that's all you do. Find a color palette that you like. I did 70s because these kind of remind me of 70s flowers, you know, those that type. But you can do any color palette you want. You could even go to coolers.co. I've shown you that, and do a random color palette and do that. So once you got your flowers and your colors, you're going to want to put them together. But before you do that, I would suggest you make different sizes. Different sizes, different colors. You can see how I kind of changed the color up on some of these. And then once you have them, put them all together and just kind of randomly place them. So let me show you what I did. You can see that right there? I'm just randomly placing the flowers here, 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 here. Now, I just used the background, that brown background. So we're using the same color palette right here. I just changed my artboard, you can see. If there's no color, this is what it looks like. But if there is a color, just do that. Now, I could do any one of these colors, right? But I already made the flowers that background. So I'm going to make the background brown here. And again, use the darker background or use a background that you're not doing the flowers in. So the background has to be one of these colors. And then color the flowers the other four colors, right? So that it stands out on it. Typically, the dark background, but you could do a reverse. You could do a light background and then do the darker colors as the flowers, either way. So I'm going to show you what this looks like on products on Redbubble and on merch by Amazon, and you can see how useful this is. You don't have to make a pattern. You could just use these and sell these as stickers. You could put this in the middle of a pop socket, right? So lots of different ways to do this. I'm just showing you a simple way. Once you have like six or seven flower patterns, you can just make your own here. Very easy to do. You can see I just randomly put it here. This isn't a repeatable pattern. This is just me putting flowers in random places. And what I like to do if you're doing this is I just like to space out the color. So if I have this color here, I surround it with other colors that aren't that color. You can see I have this lighter color next to it, and then this blue here, and then this lighter color. So kind of space out the colors just to get a variety. You don't want to put the same color everywhere. Same thing with the flower shapes. You kind of want to stagger those as well. But you can see it turned out really nice. I like it. It has that 70s feel because of the flowers and because of the colors. So let me show you what this looks like on Redbubble and merch by Amazon. So first I wanted to show you merch by Amazon. You can see I didn't put it on the shirts because I don't think it would work, but look at the pop sockets. Look at these. It's cool, right? And then the phone cases, isn't that so vintage? This is so cool with the 70s vintage. And on the bags, that looks really neat, and pillows. So lots of things you can do on merch by Amazon if you have that. If you have Redbubble, there's even more products. So check this out. I put it on Redbubble. Again, doesn't look great on the t-shirts, but look as we scroll down. Look at that dress. Very vintage, right? Very 70s. Phone case. You got mouse pads. Pillows again. Shower curtains, right? Mugs. Look at all these products you could put these flowers on. Now, again, you didn't use anything else but Affinity Designer. And look what you can do with it. You can literally make thousands of these with all the different flowers that we talked about and different colors. You could have a whole store with these, obviously. So I just love these. Real easy to do. You can see I did it in just a few minutes. So if you did one of these a day or more, you could fill a store with these. And I think it just gives a really cool look, right? And I didn't add any leaves or branches or anything like that. You could do that as well, but this is just flowers and the shapes. So cool leggings as well, backpacks. I think it looks really, really cool right there too, and masks. So have fun with this. So you can see how many products you can put this on just using Affinity Designer and colors and the shapes. And you saw how many different shapes you could do by changing how many leaves and petals are and just the different things. So have fun with this. This is a cool thing to do. I think anybody can do it. So have fun with these and make lots of different flower patterns for your print on demand products. That is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Hopefully this video was very helpful for you. If it was, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there. The question of the day for this video is, have you tried these different shapes in Affinity Designer? And which one is your favorite? Leave those in the comments below. If you've made flowers or made other things with the shapes in Affinity Designer, I'd love to hear about it. Thanks again for watching. And if you want to see more Affinity Designer tutorials, make sure to click on these right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.